Welcome back. This is going to sound a little funny, but I want you to think of yourselves as a neurosurgeon, because in this video, we're going to look into the brains of the operation. The SDDC manager is responsible for all things infrastructure related in a VCF domain. We're talking about a little appliance that can orchestrate the build of an entire domain, certificate management, and all that sort of stuff. But we will cover all that in depth in future videos. Rather than talk about it, let's get started.
Because there's just so much to SDDC Manager, I'm going to focus this overview on four key aspects. We'll start with the login process. As you would with any appliance, put the URL to the appliance or the FQDN in the browser bar and hit go. Type in credentials. You may be asking yourself why I'm showing you such a trivial thing. Now, the key thing to know here is with SDDC Manager, the first login attempt, this is before you've added any identity providers, uses the administrator at vcf.local account and authenticates against the vCenter PSC and then redirects you back to the SDDC manager. So if you ever had any issues with the login attempt, that's your path that you should take to troubleshoot. So I'll hit go on this. Perfect. And we're in. The next three things that I wanted to show you were new to VCF 4.5. They are the guided setup, the guided tour, and the dashboard wasn't new, but it's pretty good to know. On first login, this is the page you will see, but at a later stage, if you've already hit don't show this again and close the page, if you want to know how to get back to it, you can just click on the menu up here and select either guided setup or guided tour. We'll start with the guided tour, and all that does is gives you a breakdown of what you should be looking at as your next steps when you log into the SDDC manager. There's also the button for take a quick tour, which will just click you around. So licensing is obviously very important. Network settings is also very important. Hosts, where you commission hosts so you can build a workload domain. Workload domains, which is next, and then it's done at that point, basically. The next one is the guided setup. In guided setup, there are three steps, essentially. Step one, start subscription. So that's all your VCF plus cloud services gateway, subscription, cloud-based modeling type stuff. I won't be able to go into that in this course because I don't have access, but that is where you would go if you wanted to start with the guided tour. Step two is learn and plan. Learn and plan ties back into VBS. Then the third step is to configure certain things in SDDC Manager. I'll go to learn and plan, and you can see I've already gone through a few things. It's good to go through this, but it goes through common terminology, operational readiness, what the steps to achieving a functional VCF domain would be, then controls. This is important. Traditionally speaking, an administrator would do everything in vCenter. But now that you've got SDDC Manager, which I've said before is the brains of the operation, anything infrastructural needs to be done through SDDC Manager, as it has its own database. It orchestrates a lot of the configuration and deployment. Any day-to-day VM management and that sort of stuff will go through vCenter server. You don't want to be going into vCenter and adding hosts, modifying hosts, all that sort of stuff. That's a big no-no, and it could cause issues with you for you down the track. So in the learning plan, we've got four main categories. We've got the VCF strategy, preparing, then creating a VR workload domain, and finally operating and extending. I won't go through all of these, but it's good to get your head around this when you do get around to it. Go back to guided setup, and then finally we've got step three, configure SDDC Manager, and we will actually go through all these points in detail. I'll have subsequent videos that will demonstrate all of these things. Finally, the dashboard. This is a really good snapshot, as I've said, of everything you've got that SDDC knows about. Recent tasks, CPU and memory usage or utilization. We've got host types, we've got workload domains, and if you've deployed any solutions, they'll be there. If you don't know what solutions are, we'll go through that shortly. As a last bit of bonus content, because we've gone through that as a lot quicker than I had mentioned, if you scroll all the way down to the on the left-hand side and go to Developer Center, everything API related for SDDC Manager can be found here. Now, keep in mind, pretty much anything you're doing in SDDC Manager can be done by API. And if you really wanted to do things automated, if you say had a VRA blueprint form to build a workload domain, commission a host, it is definitely going to tap into API. So this will be your source of truth for anything API. I really want to get you through more things, but I like to do things in bite-sized chunks, and we're definitely going to go through all the other options in the navigation pane in subsequent videos. I know that was a quick intro to the SDDC, but if you're anything like me, you probably learn better from actually doing the work. That's exactly what we're going to do. We're going to go through each operation and get you as familiar with it as possible. But if you have no idea how we got to this point, it'd be worthwhile checking out this video, which shows you the Cloud Builder appliance, which is mandatory to actually have a VCF domain. Then after that, click here, which will take you through the deployment parameters spreadsheet, which is all the configuration to bring up this domain. And then finally here to actually see the bring up process. If you found this content useful, please let me know by liking, subscribing, and leaving a comment. It does really help out. Thank you.